We're looking at the NS1 protein, which is a protein from a group of viruses that includes the dengue virus and the West Nile virus. And we have determined 3D structures by X-ray crystallography of the NS1 protein from both of those viruses. Here we're looking at the protein, which you can see is a cross-shaped structure, and we're seeing the surface of it. And we're also seeing sugar molecules that decorate the outside of the virus. So a big slowdown in trying to get to this point was figuring out how to make the protein with all those sugars. And once we did that, we were able to get the crystal structure. This cross-like structure has two faces. The one that's facing us now, we've painted blue because it's polar, it likes water. And this is the side that has all these decorated sugar molecules on it. Now, the other face of the protein is very different. When NS1 is made by virus-infected cells, it associates with membranes inside the cell and somehow helps the virus genome to be replicated so the virus can go on and infect more cells. And this surface that's painted yellow, like butter because it's greasy, is the perfect surface for interacting with the membrane. And there's some other data that suggests that this is the part that influences replication. NS1 also gets secreted by cells and ends up in the bloodstream of people who are infected with flaviviruses. And in this case, it's the blue outer surface that is interacting with other molecules that are in the bloodstream, most specifically proteins of the immune system. What we see in the crystal structures is that NS1 can actually form a package. And we know when it's in the bloodstream that it's a protein package that contains lipid molecules. And here we've represented the lipids as a teal-colored sphere in the center. So you can see that the protein comes together to form a package with the yellow greasy bits on the inside, where they would be perfectly happy to interact with lipid molecules, and the blue polar surface and the sugars on the outside. And it's the outside part that we'll see the proteins of the immune system in the bloodstream of people who are infected with West Nile virus or other flaviviruses like dengue. What do we know that we didn't know before? Well, we know exactly what amino acids are involved in these two functions now that we have the 3D structure. And we would like to use that information to, for example, design a compound that might block the ability of NS1 to assist in the replication of the viral genome by targeting this greasy surface, or perhaps even use all or part of NS1 as a vaccine so that we can expose people to NS1 but not the virus and protect them from a viral infection or from ever being made sick by dengue virus or West Nile virus.